Hey all, it's me Gina. Today I'm going to share red velvet cake recipe with cream cheese frosting. Valentine's Day is around the corner and this is going to be a part of a smashable heart cake recipe. Let's start the preparations. Sieve 1 cup all-purpose flour or maida, 1 tablespoon unsweetened cocoa powder, 1/2 teaspoon baking powder, 1/2 teaspoon baking soda, 1/4 teaspoon salt. Set this dry mix aside. In a bowl, add 1 stick unsalted butter. It has to be kept at room temperature. It's 113 grams or 4 ounces. Add 1/2 cup sugar and beat for 3 minutes. Then add 2 eggs, adding them one at a time. Beat for 3 to 4 minutes. Add 1/2 cup vegetable oil, 1/2 cup buttermilk, 1 teaspoon vinegar, and 2 teaspoons of vanilla essence. Beat for a minute. Now add the dry mix to this and mix for about 10 seconds. Add 1 tablespoon red food coloring and blend well. I am taking a 6-inch cake pan. Pour the batter into a pan. Preheat the oven to 160 degrees Celsius or 350 degrees Fahrenheit and bake for 45 minutes. The baking time can vary depending on your oven. So check the cake after baking 25 minutes by inserting a skewer or toothpick. If the skewer comes out clean, the cake is ready. Tap to remove air pockets. Cake is now ready. Let it cool for 5 minutes. Flip the cake onto a wired rack and allow the cake to cool to room temperature. Next, we will prepare the frosting. In a large bowl, add 226 g or 8 ounce cold cream cheese, 1/2 cup powdered sugar, 1/4 teaspoon vanilla essence. Beat it for a minute. Keep aside. In a bowl, add 1 cup cold heavy whipping cream and beat it well for about 3 to 4 minutes until peaks are formed. Add the previously prepared mix into this and combine them well. The cream cheese frosting should be silky smooth but firm enough to frost the cake. Apply a layer of the frosting on the cake and refrigerate for about 15 minutes. Then apply the second layer of frosting. Frosting is done. We will refrigerate it. Let's see the smashable cake preparation. The first step is to melt chocolate. I have taken 200 grams of meltable white chocolate. The chocolate is then chopped into small pieces and then transferred into a glass bowl. In a saucepan, add some water and bring it to simmer. Place this glass bowl over the saucepan. Ensure that glass bowl is dry and the water does not touch the bottom of the bowl. Once the chocolate begins to melt, stir the chocolate pieces gently with a dry rubber spatula. It's important that water or moisture does not come in contact with the chocolate because that would make it clumpy. Once the chocolate melts completely, separate the glass bowl from the saucepan and keep it on top of a kitchen towel. The whole process will take about 4 to 5 minutes. Alternately, you could even microwave the chocolate as per the instructions on the packet. Pour the melted chocolate into a silicone mold and swirl it in all directions in a way that chocolate coats the mold entirely. Then pour the excess chocolate into a bowl. Clean the edges and let it sit in the refrigerator for 5 minutes until it sits completely. Take out the mold and do a second coating and allow this to sit in the refrigerator for 5 to 10 more minutes. Check the area near the edges of the mold. If required, apply a third coating, focusing on the edges. Separate the chocolate from mold by gently peeling away at the edges first. And then slowly continue to separate the mold from the chocolate. Our white chocolate heart is now ready. We can now decorate the red velvet cake and the chocolate heart as per our wish. I am putting some heart-shaped sprinkles on the cake. Now place the mold on top of the cake. Decorate the heart. The smashable cake is now ready. Have fun smashing it with your loved ones. Alternately, you can place a surprise gift or candies inside the chocolate heart. Have a love-filled Valentine's Day.